A lot of people say that they were made like this, that they were born this way, that they were born a homosexual. I actually thought that way myself for a while. And what I came to realize is that how I got this way, I honestly don't really know how I got this way, but I know it's contrary to what God's word said. God's word is very clear. People try to suppress that truth. They try to change it. They try to make it fit their needs. But it's not what God's word says. God's word is very clear that it's wrong. So for those that say it's natural, it's normal, that's the same thing I felt at first. After I realized what I'd done, I enjoyed the sexual pleasure of it. I enjoyed the sinful nature of it. Sin is pleasurable for a season. But eventually that season ends and we're without hope. We're going to hell. We're going to pay for that sin. Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor idolaters, nor homosexuals, nor sodomites, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners will inherit the kingdom of God. So I would say that any that think it's normal that to examine yourself and to make sure that what you're feeling is normal isn't really the sinful pleasure that you're enjoying. Because that is normal, that is natural. It is natural for a fallen man to enjoy sin and to take great pleasure from it. I know it was in my life, I enjoyed my sin. That's what I didn't want to give up. I didn't want to give up that sin. But then when I drew near to God and He showed me the truth that I would never be forgiven, I would never be able to fall at the cross until I gave up that sin. That sin that I love, that sin I tried to hold on to. And so I did. I cast it at the cross and I jumped out in a leap of faith to Christ and He saved me from it. He redeemed me from it. He made me a real person. That's how I know what I'm telling you is true, because He changed me. He made me a new person with the new desires. He took away all those sinful desires and made me a new creature. And He can do the same for you. He saved me from the power of sin, and He can save you too. And I pray that you would cry out to Him, that you could be made a new creature and be freed from your sinful lifestyle, from your sin that holds you captive. Even though you may be a willing captive to it right now, someday you're going to be a captive of hell, paying the justice that's due, paying the ransom that's due, because you'll find on that day that Christ didn't suffer your sins on the cross, you're suffering your sins now.